Welcome to the old boar plays City Skylines. In this video, I'll be putting in a cargo harbor and docks. And I'll be putting in some piers and ferry lines. I'm using tides in this series. A real location of a map I made in Umajima, Japan, where I use satellite imagery and OpenStreetMap lay out my roads. Thanks for all your support on this channel. But first, draw an outline around your harbor. If you have image overlay too and you want to use that satellite imagery, turn it on. This is where the pier goes. Once you have the lines of your harbor laid out, you can level everything up. Make sure your height is good so that your tides aren't coming into your city. Now I want to draw roads all the way around my harbor, my pier area. When you talk about docks and piers, docks are for usually unloading and loading cargo. Piers are usually for loading and unloading passengers. This is a nice asset called the HarborPack. I'm getting the measurement for that container yard there. Now I'm putting in a 5-unit street around the harbor so that the trucks can turn around. These warehouse assets are 3 pieces, center, left, and right. I'll put a link to all these in the description below. I want to make sure it's flat so that the parking lots don't look wanky. I spend a lot of time going through the Steam Workshop in the evening and trying out assets in game till I get the right ones. This is a little town, it's right next to the harbor. raising up the height as my tide comes in over the roads. So to create a ferry, I want to put in a ferry path, kind of like a plinth path or a train line. You're bringing connections off of it, putting one all the way around the island. And I'll lower down the sea level around that just a bit. This is a nice set of assets called piers, and it gives you all the pieces. You want to point the arrow towards your ferry path or away from land. This is the ferry depot. Now I'll add a ferry stop. Dark green dots, I think you're supposed to connect another piece of ferry path from it to the ferry depot. We'll find out if it works. So now I'll connect the ferry depot to the ferry path. Not for sure if these are necessary. And we'll bring a ferry out to this little island here. This just needs a ferry stop. Make sure it's at a distance from the land. Now I'll connect the stop with the pier path. I want to create a line from one stop to the next. So I'm going to connect this stop to the ferry path. And now we'll create a line just like we would a bus or a train line. And I'll lower the number of ferries that are coming up. I'm just going to give it one. I'm going to go ahead and delete these out. Hopefully they're not necessary. Pier paths with a fenced and a non-fenced unit. I like the fenced. This is a really nice hat set called Container Feeder. It has a ship and two container packs that switch out the containers. I put in some vanilla keys and the other asset to the HarborPack. It doesn't float. When the tide goes out, you can see the bottom of it, but I'm okay with it. And I'm using Stone Key 2, downloadable asset. It's a little bit more like my map theme. Now I'm going to use a terraforming tool. Take care of those rough edges. Just move the terraforming segment in to clean up that. Now I'm going to align heights with move it, and I'm using the hotkey Control H, highlight the section that you want to level to, and the white circle is the height that it'll go to. Most people put the quays in before the roads, but I like a little bit of space between my quays. This particular quay, I'm going to lower it down gradually into that little harbor. And again with the terraforming tool, I'm going to make this one just a little higher, but I can gradually bring that dock down to the sea level. Need to raise up my roads a bit more. This is a nice set of asset called docks. Big piece will go out toward the water. If you want to place any of those other assets, you'll need prop anarchy for that. Now I'm using DIY concrete dock pack. It's just the basic dock, nothing that comes to it. There's one for passenger and cargo. This is the prop. cargo dock, you'll need to have it connected to an outside line. These boats actually float, and they'll go up and down with your tide. seen my other videos, this is the pre-detailing phase, just getting in the basic elements so that I can come in later and do the detailing. And I'll go ahead and start to put in the little town. They're utility poles, and I don't really need the electricity. They really add a lot of realism. Not too fond of those buildings there, but I'll leave it. Busy little harbor. These are from the Modern Japan Content Creator Pack. Some of those buildings seem to fit. I'm finding that plopping in my houses and commercial is almost as easy as drawing them in and zoning them in. Sometimes you come back and you find that things aren't the way you put them. Not too fond of that chip. I'm gonna try a different one. I like this one better. Nice view of the island. I'll get rid of Old Man River. Something more Japanese. The little island is taking shape. I hope you're enjoying remote Japan. Stay tuned for the next video from the old boar. Take care now.